Cerium is one of only two elements which, if you strike it, will make sparks. One of them is iron, and the other one is cerium. And so I bought this when I was on holiday a year ago and haven't had a chance to use it. It consists of a rod here which has claims to have several metals, including cerium. Let's see if it sparks.
Okay, so cerium, element number 58, has some bizarre uses. Would you believe it's used in self-cleaning ovens?
So it's not very easy to do, but once you get the hang of it, it does go quite well.
Cerium also has uses such as for staining glass. So if you want to stain your glass yellow, then you can use cerium in that.
What is happening is that tiny pieces of cerium are being knocked off, and in the air, they just burst into flames. So I think the property is not so much that it forms a spark, but that you can knock off the right size lumps to make them burn. These things that are being knocked off are probably just a few nanometers, that's a thousand millionth of a meter across, so they're very tiny size, and the surface area is high because it's small, so it has a large surface compared to its volume, and so it reacts with oxygen very rapidly and heats up and bursts into flame. The point about cerium is that very small particles of cerium oxide are now becoming quite important in various areas of technology. There's a company, or several companies, that are using nanoparticles of cerium oxide as an additive for fuels to make, particularly diesel fuel, to try and make it burn better and give more power when you are driving diesel cars. And here in Nottingham, we're trying to develop new ways of making these nanoparticles by reacting cerium with high temperature water. And it's been quite successful.
It's also used in organic synthesis by chemists for making organic molecules because it can be very reactive under certain circumstances. Cerium is also used in permanent magnets for obvious applications in magnetism.